What's up, everyone? So we're back, and we're back with the they're not even throwback videos, but we're back with doing work on the car again. If you're new to this channel, this is what we're working on. This is going to be my O2 RSX Type S, K20, K24. I got full playlists on basically what I did with the motor and all the work that's been to it, but it hasn't been on the channel for a while, so we have it back in the garage. As you can see by the title, we're going to put Aerocatch hood pins on it. Now, I'm going to be straight up, like, forward with you guys. This is my second attempt at this video. First attempt, I did this like 2 years ago. I tried it, screwed the hood up so bad I scrapped all the videoing. I just bought a second hood and put it on. We're gonna try this again. I got a better idea of how I'm gonna do it. So before we even move any farther, because I'm nervous, wish me luck, like the video, comment good luck, and again, if you're new, subscribe. Let's get into this. Everyone pretty much knows what the Aerocatch hood pins are. If you don't, this is pretty much what they are. It's a latching style hood pin. So what you do is those little red strikers, pins, whatever. They go into your hood somewhere or into your somewhere underneath the engine bay, right? They go somewhere over there. And so then this is going to be on your hood, and they call it a latching system because you literally press the button, and it's like a latch. So the way it would work is, actually, you know what? Hey, check this out. So you can see how open this hole is right here. This was from me trying to make the hood pins work long time ago. Aerocatch doesn't sell these separate. You need to buy a whole new set. I'm gonna make this work. If it works out, maybe I'll decide to buy a new set later on. But basically, this is where your red pin would go through, and then the latch just kind of goes through it like that, locks it in, and that's why it's a latching system. The secret component, or the key component, that I'm going to be using this time around that I didn't have the first time is going to be these password JDM. I guess they're Aerocatch mounting plates. All right, so they're called Aerocatch mounting plates. Now, the reason why I ended up buying these, one, they actually gave me a pretty good template that's reusable to cut the actual hole on the hood. And two, the plates are aluminum, as opposed to the Aerocatch ones having plastic ones. So when you actually tighten the screws down, you're not tightening plastic, you know, steel hood, plastic. It's plastic pin, steel hood, aluminum bottom. So it's not going to crush. It's gonna take the clamping force. So I'll go more in depth about more reasons why I got this kit right here. I don't even know if they make this anymore, so I'll see if I can try to find some, check eBay, but they're password JDM Aerocatch mounting plates. I think these are going to be what save us. So being that this is an RSX, obviously this install video is going to be pretty much how to do it on an RSX, but these are universal hood pins. So it's pretty much the way I'm going to go about doing this. You could do it the same way, because pretty much every car has, you know, front radiator support where they have stuff bolted in there. So I'm going to be putting the actual pins and the radiator support, and I found these holes next to where the original hood stoppers are, and they're flat. When I close the hood, where it looks like the pin is going to be coming out of, looks perfect. I can orient the hood pin or the catch pin any way that I want. So first thing is figure out where you're going to put them, and in our case, we're going to be putting them in these two spots, or in this one spot on each side. So we're getting ready to actually start doing the drilling portion of this. So the drilling is, we're going to put a pilot hole into the hood so that way the pin can actually come through the hood and we can start figuring out where we're going to lay everything out. So a little bit of what I did already is I put masking tape on the headlights because we're going to be cutting. So all those metal shards pretty much are going to be going everywhere, little sparks. That'll destroy your plastic headlights, just putting scratches in it. So I masked up the headlights. I took out the original hood latch. So I took that out because we're going to be opening and closing the hood a lot. I don't want to have to keep unlatching it and latching it. Plus, I'm taking it out anyway for these hood pins. So that's out of the way. And I got the pins where I want them. Now, what I did was I put a little bit of like mother's aluminum polish. Basically, you want something on top of these pins that are going to leave a mark on the top of your hood. So that's all I did, was put some of this polish on here, basically because it's white, so I'd be able to see it on the black hood wherever it touches. So that's just the stuff I use. You can use grease. A lot of people use toothpaste, again, because it's white, and you need something thick. You don't need something that's just going to run off of this. So I have them adjusted. My recommendation, I could be wrong, but I'm leaving it pretty low. That way, when I come to close the hood down, the angle of this compared to when the hood comes down to touch it, it's almost like if it was fully closed. And that's another big thing when you're trying to do these. When I did it the first time, I did this exact method, but what I did was when I had the marks on the hood, I left the hood open, like in the upwards position, and I went in this way. Like I didn't line my drill bit up as if, how do I explain this? Hang on. Okay, so you guys can see this is like this. So when this hood comes down, right? So let's say my hand is the hood, it's gonna come down, it's gonna touch this way. When I opened the hood back up, I went with the drill bit kind of like at this angle because the hood was up. So I went with the drill bit like that. When, if you look at it and we were to close the hood, you can already kind of see my fingers crooked. I needed to come in with the drill bit like that to kind of give it the same angle as the pin when it was in there, if that makes sense. Angles are a big thing. So I'm gonna get that mark. I'm gonna, you know what, just watch what I'm gonna do.
Darling, you send me. Darling, you send me, I know you.
All right, check it out. So we closed the hood, as you saw. We put a little bit of pressure on both sides. So there's our mark right there. That's where we're gonna start our first pilot hole. And same thing on this side. This side left a little bit more. So what I'm gonna do right now, just for me, so I don't lose these marks, I'm gonna get like a silver Sharpie and just put a circle around where I know my initial hole is gonna be. But now, I'm not going to drill completely through this hole or through this hood. I want, because you can see there's a big gap from here to the top of the hood. And I think that was another mistake I did. I just went completely through. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start a pilot hole here, not go through the hood completely, get a hole saw and then just hole saw this section open. This hollow section right here, hole saw a bigger hole, put some more grease on this, close the hood again. That way I can get marks on closer to this end of the hood. So that way I feel like it's pretty much where that mark is gonna be is exactly where that pin's gonna come through. So check that out.
Darling, you send me. You send me. You send me. Darling,
all right, so now we have that hole drilled and we use the hole saw just to open it up a little bit. So hopefully you guys can understand what I'm gonna explain now. I put more grease on the hood pin right here. So now we get a better look. Well, the camera's not gonna get, well, you can see the two little dots of what it went through. Now I want the grease on those dots right there. Once I get grease on that end of the hood, it's gonna go completely through and I'm gonna be more confident about that hole that I make, that it's gonna line up with this pin. Example of why this method is way better than the way I originally did it. So again, we put more grease on here. Now hopefully you guys could see, but if I'm looking at this, that white mark in there is not perfectly lined up with the hole. So that's like a straight shot. You can see it's way over to the left. So if I would have went straight through, I would have been off from my pin again. So now I'm just gonna leave that mark there, drill a small pilot hole that way, and I'll line it up again.
All right, so this is great news already. So we just tried to test it out and I'm getting, you know, the white marks on the top of the hood. Like I went through it already, there's no going back. So like everything is lining up, check this out.
All right, so there's our hole that we made that went all the way through. So if you watch that as I come down, you see it turns white, that's the grease from that. So that means we're pretty much lined up. So now we're gonna step one size up on the drill bit and follow the same line, the same angle that we did it, because I think it's the angle. I have Nicole here holding the hood for me. And hopefully it'll get bigger and it'll just allow the pin to come through a little more.
After multiple drill bits, multiple attempts, work your way up very slowly. That's the best advice I can give you. It actually goes through, like it's so good. It's perfect, so check this out.
All right, so we're gonna close the hood. There's our hole that we ended up going to that size. And if it's perfect, I mean, it drags it just a little bit, but I ain't worried about that. But to be safe, we're gonna do the other side now to see if when we open this side up, it might not touch anymore. All it is just scraping a little bit, but we're gonna do the same exact process on this side right here. Same thing we did here. And we'll come back when we got both of them open, and then we're gonna start putting the latches in.
Yo, I'm so hyped right now. I'm so hyped that they actually went through. I think this is the hardest part, in my opinion. This is the most nerve-wracking, the hardest part, but they lined up. Now it's gonna be easier because of the template I got. Now we're gonna use the password JDM kit that I bought to show you guys why I think it's gonna be easier. But like, yo, it worked. The one side, I'll be honest, the passenger side, it didn't line up perfectly when I did the hole saw. So I just had to open it up a little bit with a Dremel. You won't really notice. You wouldn't notice if I didn't tell you. So yeah, so let me bring, now I gotta bring the hood pins lower because we have to put this password JDM template on it.
All right guys, so we have tape put down where the hood pins are gonna, the latches are gonna be cut into the hood. And this is one of the reasons why I was telling you guys I really like this kit. Because they gave you this plastic template that you can reuse. And I just liked it because it was plastic, because I can reuse it. But basically we dropped the pin low enough to try to get this to sit as flat as possible. The hood does have a little bit of a curve to it. That's just the way the hood is. So if you leave it like that, you're gonna see there's just gaps right here. So you'd have to hold this down by hand to try to get as close of a cut as you can. So we're going to trace this, start cutting with a Dremel. And the other reason why I like the password kit is because of the plates, the locking plates they give you. So this is the original Aerocatch one. It's made out of plastic, and what you would do is you put nuts in here and tighten it down. With the password JDM one, it's made out of aluminum, it's anodized, and it's threaded, so you don't have to use the nuts. You just put a little bit of blue Loctite with your screws and you tighten it like that. Benefit about this one is they'll actually give you little two studs. So you put one stud on each corner. So when you actually cut this to your opening, before you put your hood pin in there, you're gonna get this guy. You're actually gonna slide it in to under the hood. So basically with this piece, you don't have to cut the underside of the hood to a giant opening. This will actually slide in there, and the two studs they give you, you could stud it, pull it up from the holes that you're gonna make, and it's already, your base plate is under there without cutting the underside of the hood. Sounds confusing, but you'll understand once we start doing it. So we're going to trace this, start cutting it, and then start fitting. All right, the holes are made. That was pretty scary. But as you guys saw, you just start tracing it. I used the hole saw to try to get around the cut ends, and it's just a lot of cut, trim a little bit, fit it, trim it, fit it, trim it, fit it, until you finally get it. So I finally got it, and eventually what I did, because you can see I already made some holes in there for the bolts, I just put it in and just ran the drill bit through it with it like that. So now I want to show you guys what I was talking about with this plate, with the new the password JDM one. So I'm going to put you on a tripod, and you're going to see how this works without having to cut the bottom side. This is just obviously for the pin, but without cutting the bottom side of your hood and making it look all, you know, ugly. It doesn't matter which way you put this guy on, it's just any way. So it could be with the lettering up or down, doesn't matter. So you're gonna just slide this in. It's gonna be tight, especially on my hood because it's just not sliding in all the way. So you just gotta force it in a little bit till you get it. Then they give you these two little threaded rods, okay? So you're gonna pull it back up with these rods. So you're just going to pull this up and just start one. And just thread it a little bit. And go on the opposite side. And that's it. So now you got your base plate underneath here without having to cut the underside of the hood. So now this is just going to go right over the studs. Everything fits, and then you just start running your bolts in. You don't need any nuts, put some Loctite on them, and the hood pin is in. And then the only thing, well, the latch is in. The only thing you have to do now is put the pin back in and adjust your height so you can latch it, and that's it.
Man, check this out. This is a big mile, not a big milestone, but this is like a big deal from totally screwing this job up years ago
to actually having one completely in, functioning. And I've always wanted this look and these hood pins, so it's like such a relief to have one done. Just check it out. All right, here's our passenger side, completely done, bolted in. Our lock is adjusted, so it goes in and out, nice, and we lock it. And I mean, that one's still up, so the hood's gonna be a little lopsided, but this thing is working great. Pop it open. Thing is good. That's the adjustment. I'm gonna tighten that up a little more just to be safe, but look, the thing just closes good. Oh, thank God. Do the whole process on that side again and we'll close this out. It's finally done, guys. The hood latches are on. They look great. It's the look I want. I haven't taken the tape off yet because, well, I gotta vacuum the whole engine bay before I even take the cover off. But I wanna show you guys how they look, how they function, and yeah, man, I'm so happy I got them. So there you go, you got both of them symmetrical, working perfectly. So we're just gonna lock this in. Again, we did the adjustments on that side already and everything. Lock this in. I adjusted it so that way there wasn't a lot of play coming up with the hood. So that way you could see there's a little bit of play. I'll see if I can try to get rid of that. But yeah, so now we'll pop it open. There you go, that one's good. And they work. So I'm probably gonna see if I put the rubber stoppers here. So the rubber stoppers are these guys that comes with them. Let's see, I took them off somewhere. Oh, here they are. So there's a, that's not it. Where's the, oh, they're in here. So they give you these rubber stoppers, and basically what these do, they're going to replace your OEM hood stopper. So if I wanted to, I could take this out, slide this guy over here, see how much I have to trim, and that way the hood is going to rest on here instead of all the weight being on the inside of the latch right here, just resting on nothing. So I'm going to figure out what length I need, cut it, put the rubber stoppers, and that's it. So I mean, even with the one right there, we could probably, it's not even going to go over. Well, it goes over, but it won't latch anymore, so I have to like find the right size. So I got that to latch. And there's no more movement going down with the hood. It's just a buffer. So that's done off camera. So this 2-year nightmare that I've had of doing these latches is finally over. And I needed to do it now just because, well, the car is going for paint, as you guys know. So I wanted to cut on a car that's not painted yet. If I was going to mess it up right now, I was just going to buy a carbon fiber hood at this point, because I'm not going to buy another hood to try it again. But the password JDM kit worked. Taking your time worked. The cutting through the hood twice, so that way you leave the mark on the top part of the skin. That worked perfectly, and really big thank you to my fiance. She was a big help. She's exhausted right now. It's really hot. You can kind of see it. I'm glistening. Yo, can we take a break and talk about I finally got a haircut? Like, it's been so long, and I've been looking crazy with hats on, and I finally got a haircut, so I'm happy about that. I feel normal again. And yeah, so what's next? Next, the car's got to go to Mako. The car's getting painted by Mako. And don't even start flaming me in the comments, all right? Like, I'll explain what's going on in the paint video. But I got to go get a final estimate. So what they did was they gave me an estimate without seeing the car. I got to bring the car to them now so we can finally get like a final number, because it has rust on the bottom quarter. The door's kicked in. I have small dents that I want them to do. I don't even feel like fixing it. Please, big thumbs up if you guys enjoyed this video. I'm glad it's done, it's working. Now it looks a little more like a track car with diffusers, the hood pins. It's the look I'm going for, but I also race it. So it's not a look, it's functionality for me. I don't have to rely on the OEM latch. These latches are gonna hold the hood down. Hold the hood down fine. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Leave some good comments. Like the video, all right? I'm back on YouTube. We gotta get our thing going. We hit 18,000 subscribers, so thank you guys. Yeah, we hit 18,000, so I saw that the other day. Let's get back on this, all right? We fell off. Let's get this channel moving again. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Stay motivated and keep making those streets louder.